Hi, this evening I will be speaking at the World HR Congress 2021 being held at Colombo, Sri Lanka by the World Federation for HRM Associations, and this is being organized by the Chartered Institute of Personnel Management of Sri Lanka. I'm grateful to them for giving me the opportunity and privilege to be a keynote speaker in the inaugural session of this World Congress. I just want to inform my friends the main points that I like to be talking this evening in my talk. The talk is titled as New Vistas of Human Possibilities Management. I would like to refer to this morning's one of the newspaper's headlines says, Omicron plunges the world into collective uncertainty. It's a very interesting representation of what has been happening in the last 2 years. Plunges the world into collective uncertainty. For my talk on new vistas of human possibilities, I kept thinking, what is it that post-pandemic the world will look like? And what is the role of the HR profession and HR managers? As most of you know, I have lifted off the HR profession theoretically to say that HR professionals, if they are true to their profession, are both saviors of human beings as well as providers of economic activity for human beings. They not only save lives but also help in creating livelihoods. This lifts them up far beyond the CEOs. I also maintain that all CEOs of corporations and presidents of countries, prime ministers of countries, have the single most important role of continuously educating people and facilitating learning. And revisited Maslow's need hierarchy to say the most important need today is the need for survival. Then comes the security needs, which include health security, economic security, emotional security, financial security, and so on. And then the third order, and that is the end of it, is the need for identity. So I'm going to talk of the way HRM has evolved in the last 100 years. Most of HRM concepts, largely derived also from organizational behavior or behavioral sciences, in the last 100 years have evolved from in the corporate sector. Whereas I think today, all employees in the corporate sector, exclude the government, informal sector, NGOs and others, may constitute only a small part of the population, significant part, important part of the population. So the HR concepts that have evolved in corporate sector context need to be relooked at, and we need to evolve concepts in the larger societal interests, the global kind of interests. The closest I can think of that came to this is the Human Development Report, started in 1990, almost about 30 years ago, which focused on HRD of countries as the ability to live longer, ability to have good schooling and education, and the ability to have a good quality of life. Barring this, we did not have much of the expansion of. Now, I like to propose this new concept of human possibilities development, which as a kind of a substitute or as a kind of a further development over human resources development. This is because resources have certain limitations in terms of the connotation. Possibilities open up these limitations. Although we always maintain human beings are born with unlimited resources, I think many people in the corporate context have reduced these resources to key performance areas, targets, and almost made human being as a commodity to be transacted. That's where I think this new concept of human possibilities development opens up vistas to look at every human being as a possible contributor. The biggest evidence we have got is in the last 2 years, when what takes probably decades to discover and put in operation vaccines have been done, discovered within a year's time and have been put into operation in less than 2 years. I think this is the human possibility. I think for every opportunity or every problem that we have, human beings have a phenomenal amount of opportunity to tackle them. So essentially, my talk is going to talk about to present this new approach to HRD as human possibilities development, and what new vistas this particular approach opens up, and how do we look at the entire field of HRM as human possibilities management field, and what is the meaning that appraisals, induction, recruitment, promotions, engagement surveys, and all these kind of things look at. This is what, in essence, I am likely to cover. I'll probably be highlighting, I'll also be proposing the need for a new cadre of HR professionals who I have earlier talked about as human possibility volunteers. I think this is probably the direction in which the world should go to make every human being a human resource manager for his own, her own resources, or human possibilities manager, where every person should constantly explore during his or her lifetime whatever is possible for him or her to achieve and reach the self-actualization level. This is just some glimpses of what I intend to say. I may be saying a lot more. By chance, if you are able to, if you have not registered, register for this conference, World HR Congress 2021 at Colombo, being organized by the World Federation of Personal Management Associations and also the Chartered Institute of Personal Management in Sri Lanka. All the best, and hope you will enjoy my talk if you get to hear the whole thing.